Welcome to the Riviera Theater in North Tonawanda, where the sound of the mighty Wurlitzer organ has been popular for generations. Thanks to the Niagara Frontier Theater Organ Society, we'll be there for future generations. Society Vice Chairman Don Lang tells us about the majestic old movie house.
Well, it was built in 1926. Originally, it was built by the Yellen family. It was taken over by the Shays, went through the Dipson Theater chain, and from then on, it went through a whole bunch of private individuals. And just recently, the Niagara Frontier Theater Organ Society purchased it in order to save it from destruction. We've been correcting a lot of defects in the building. Electrical, plumbing. We are coming up with having to repair the roof, or actually replace the roof. We've done some repairs on it. And we are conducting a fund drive to replace the seat, or repair the seats. All the workers are volunteers, with the exception of the projectionist and our general manager.
What type of programming do you have in addition to this mighty Wurlitzer organ?
We're running movies 7 nights a week. We're going to have matinees. We're getting a lot of live entertainment. We have a circus booked in, a small circus, a magic show.
But what can you tell me about this beautiful console? Where did it come from originally?
Well, it was built right here in North Tonawanda at the Wurlitzer plant. It was built for the theater. It was installed in the theater when the theater opened in 1926. It was a demonstrator model for the company.
The artist in residence for this performance was George Cragey of Cleveland, who has been in love with the theater organ for 20 years. This was his 13th appearance here.
This was basically designed to replace a full orchestra to do the movie scores, the movie soundtrack, the movie music of the old silent movies.
Of Pauline right now.
There are three manuals, which means there are three sets of keys.
Mm-hmm.
And then there are two rows of stop tabs, which control the sets of pipes that the keys play.
Now, there's so many special effects. Now, we were looking at them down the line. Now, we saw, first of all, the cathedral chimes.
Okay. Those are played from the keyboard.
How about your Chinese gong?
Chinese gong is played with the left foot.
And a snare drum.
Snare drum is done with the left hand.
And horse's hooves?
Horse's hooves. That's done way over here with the right foot.
There were some castanets, too.
Okay, castanets.
And the old fire bell.
Fire bell is done with the left foot.
I just peeked behind the curtain to the right of the stage from the audience view, and I saw some pipes there. What can you tell me about those pipes?
Well, those are foundation pipes, real low notes. And then backstage, hanging on the wall, there's a set of what we call a solo strings. Mm-hmm. Those could be comparable to a bass violin.
We climbed the ladder, and what do we find up there?
Up there, there's a lot of sets of pipes, which produce various sounds. There's tubas, English horns, orchestral oboes.
I noticed some horizontal, flat-type pipes. What were they over on the other side?
Those are diaphones.
What
those,
do they do?
Those also produce very low notes. They're the bass notes.
Where's the brains of all of this?
The brains?
There must be some kind of a central relay station, whatever you would call it.
Everything goes from the console down into the basement through a switching central down there, which would be comparable to a telephone switchboard.
And overall, how many pipes would you say
there's
you
approximately 3,000.
Oh my, different sizes and
different
materials?
Sizes, ranging from about a half inch long, about the size of a diameter of a lead pencil, to the biggest one is 16 foot long and about a foot and a half square. In addition to the pipes, we have various sound effects. We have a player piano hooked up to it, an xylophone.
Neil Lang, chairman of the Niagara Frontier.